Hi, my name is Alex Rainbird, and I've been making playlists on YouTube every month for the last 10 years. Right now it's November 2013, and way back in November...
What? No, it's not.
It's
2023.
Yeah, I know. Right now it's November 2023, and way back in November 2013, I uploaded my first playlist to YouTube. It looked something like that. Just like that. I've always loved that feeling of finding a brand new artist or band that none of my friends or family have ever heard of. In 2011, I started uploading some of these songs to YouTube, mostly just to have them all in the same place so I can find them, and never imagining that anyone would find or care about my little YouTube channel. But I was wrong, and people actually started subscribing. I could not believe it. I did this for a couple of years, just uploading songs here and there. And I woke up one day and thought, how cool would it be to put 10 of my favorite indie songs in the same video and just spend some time like ordering them to give the best sort of experience to the listener discovering these songs. Up to that point, I'd had about 1,000 subscribers. So that was in November 2013, and that was my first ever monthly playlist video. It was so fun putting it together and received a lot more views than just the regular single track uploads. So from that point forward, I decided to make one every month, and I'd never ever imagined that 10 years later I'd still be doing it. As I kept making these monthly playlists while at university, I couldn't believe that artists and bands and musicians were contacting me via email to be featured on the playlist, and it blows my mind. It did then, and it still continues to now. And then after graduating, I finally moved in with my long-term girlfriend, and now my fiance, Beth Patterson. Hey!
You right? Hi, you right? And since then, we've both been making monthly playlists featuring the world's best independent artists.
We've also expanded now to social media, making playlists on Spotify and Apple Music. We've done a podcast, a record label.
We also organised an Alex Rainbird Music live show in London in 2019. And next month, in December 2023, we've actually helped to plan a show at the world famous Carnegie Hall.
What?
Madness, absolute madness. And tickets are on sale now.
And we'll be there, and hopefully we'll see you there too.
We've also been so lucky to travel around Europe and America and meet some of the incredible artists that we've featured on the playlist, as well as their amazing teams as well.
And over the years, we've built an incredible community of over 1 million people from around the world. And it's mad that our videos can now help boost a rising independent artist's career. That's insane.
It's so insane. So crazy. To celebrate 10 years of making playlists on YouTube, we actually asked our community to send in their questions. So we thought we'd answer some of them for you today. And you get to know us a bit more.
Okay, so the first one, we actually had the same question from a few people, in particular, Lucky Little Unicorn 2885 on YouTube, and also Carol Nell on Facebook. Both asked similar questions. Basically, how do we find like the artists and the music that we feature on our playlists?
It's pretty much everywhere.
It's everywhere
now, isn't it?
Yeah, obviously, as I said, it started back for me just reaching out to an artist, and now we get submissions.
I think primarily we listen to music on SubmitHub emails and Groover,
yeah.
Yeah.
There are some submission platforms that have popped up over the years, and they're all brilliant. And we still do go out and find music. We listen to Spotify playlists and all those sort of things, recommendations. And and still contact artists to this day asking if they want to work with us.
Yeah. Okay, so the next one is from Jenny Goodridge YouTube. How many hours of researching, listening and crafting goes into a playlist? It's a good question.
Oh my goodness, that is a good question. We make a whole big list in January, the start of every year, about what playlists we want to do this year, basically. And from then on, we're looking for songs. Yeah, we're always listening and thinking, oh, this could be a good fit for this relaxing playlist or this nighttime playlist.
It does take a very long time. Doesn't it?
It takes longer than you can, yeah. It takes
longer than you think.
Longer than you think, yeah. Because we maybe approve for the playlist about 5% of the songs that we feature. And when you think a playlist might have like 40 songs on it, yeah. So that might give you some sort of rough idea about how many songs you listen to. But literally from the beginning of the day to the end, we always are both either listening together
to
or listening separately to a submission or something. So yeah, a lot. Of listening.
A lot of time.
Okay, so next one is from Cloud on our Discord server, who said, are we going to have an Alex Rainbird Music concert one day and where. As we said earlier, we've had an incredible opportunity to work with the organisers of a show at Carnegie Hall in New York City, which is one of the most prestigious venues in America, yeah, or some crazy thing like that.
It's been so crazy. It's been so fun and amazing to be there. Other than that, right now we don't currently have any shows planned.
No.
But it's something that we really want to get into in the future. Maybe definitely another London show. Maybe we'll
let us know
where you want us to go
in the comments, where you want us to bring your favourite artists to. And also about the Carnegie Hall show, tickets are on sale,
so
make sure you grab your ticket before they're all gone.
The next one is also from YouTube, and it's from Someone Somewhere 9699, and they asked, how do you guys find new songs and ideas for playlists? I feel like playlists all come from how we're feeling, based on a feeling of wanting to escape or relax, or I don't know, go on adventures. And
I feel like we get inspired, like when we get submissions and songs, we, I guess, just pick up on the mood or like the vibe of each song and think, okay, this could be really cool as a whole playlist.
Yeah.
Like a wanderlust travel-y one, or something warm and cozy, or a coffee house vibe, I don't know.
Yeah.
I guess it's just like, our experiences, our lives, plus the songs and how they feel. Does that make sense?
It's definitely a mix of both.
We make a big list of ideas that we're always updating to, and as I said at the start of every year, we look at that and think, okay, that could be cool for August, maybe that for November, and like sort of put it all into that, and hopefully never run out of ideas. Fingers crossed. Again, in the comments, any ideas for playlists, leave them down there.
Yes.
Okay, one more question from Facebook, from Andreas Miranda. Hopefully I said that right. Hi, I've been listening to your music list for a little over 5 years now. Wow.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
And I have some questions. What list has been the most difficult to make? I think because we've made now two instrumental playlists.
Yeah.
And they've been the most difficult in some ways, like it's a completely different thing, like instrumental music and trying to order 30, 40 songs into like a playlist and thinking, okay, how does this one with no vocals and a very relaxed vibe flow best into the next one, and trying to like figure that all out?
I have one. I think the best of the year playlists are really difficult to do.
That's true.
Because how do you, like, everything's amazing.
Yeah.
So it's really difficult to get like 40 songs from the year. It's usually like 40, 50, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
From the year. It's really, really difficult to just do. Because that's a small amount compared to how many songs we feature in the year. So that's my one. So
that's a good one.
And we'll be doing another one soon. So good luck to us.
Watch out, yeah. And there's one more question on there from Andreas. He said, where are you from?
Oh.
We're from the UK.
Yeah.
If you couldn't tell.
And then the last question. Can I just say we had so many questions, but we don't want to...
Waste your time.
So, but thank you so much, everyone, for all of the questions. There were so many. And it was difficult to pick just six.
Yeah, just a handful,
but,
yeah.
The last one's from Adrian DLC on Instagram. Hi, Adrian, if you're watching.
Adrian.
What has felt like the biggest accomplishment in the past decade? Also, love you guys. Love you too.
Love you too, Adrian.
I've got two.
One of them will be mine. But okay. I guess we'll add two.
I'll go for two. The first one was 1 million subscribers, because I feel like it was building, and we were building it for a very long time.
Yeah.
That number was slowly creeping closer to us, and then when we finally reached it, it was really beautiful actually, because it was in lockdown.
Yeah.
So it was just us two, and we did like a little 1 million party. We saw 1 million pop up together, and we both cried. So it was really special. And then my other one is the London live show.
Taking the two best ones.
Sorry.
No, go.
Because that was our first live show, and it was a really big moment just to take Alex Rainbird Music into the real world. I just can't wait to do more, hopefully, in the future, because that was a really special evening.
It was so special. And just to add on to that, this isn't, I guess, I do have one as well. So, but to meet, because we've been lucky enough to travel to meet artists in person, but to be in a room where there's like fans and like subscribers in our community who love the same music, and do you know what I mean? And actually meeting people was, emotional and amazing. And as you said, we can't wait to do it again as soon as possible. And my proudest accomplishment, I guess, is kind of part of the 1 million, the celebration for that. We organised over, again, months, a lot of our evenings and weekends we spent making a festival, like an online virtual. It was 4 hours long. Over 50 artists, I believe, were kind enough to send in a video. They performed their songs to celebrate this amazing milestone. And in between that, we had messages from our community. They sent in little video messages saying how thankful they were, and it's just mad.
It's so special.
It's so special. Yeah, so 2011 I started, 2013 was the first playlist, but 12 years, get on for 13, it's an incredible thing that everyone, for everyone to come together and just love independent music, so. Yeah.
And also it's still, it's on the channel.
It is.
So you can go and watch it back.
And if you love live sessions and live performances like that, we have something very special coming in 2024.
Yeah.
Sneak peek. Stay tuned.
Yeah. That's all the questions. And again, just thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah. We are so grateful to each and every one of you for sitting through this whole video and for watching and for just coming back every month, for listening to these playlists that we still make all this time later. It means everything.
Yeah, it means everything. Thank you so much, honestly. That means so much to us. Take care and we'll see you soon.
See you soon.
Bye.
Bye.